Welcome to part two of our tutorial on painting the orc Morkanaut. Now in this part, we're going to be painting all the metallic areas of the model, so things like the joints and pistons and exhausts, that kind of thing. And also, we're going to be painting the details, so targeting lenses and lights and cables. So go and get your paints and brushes, let's get to it. So, I'm going to begin with the metallic areas, and most of those are silver, so I'm going to begin with those. Now, the base colour for this is Lead Belcher, and the brush I'm going to use most of the time is a large brush, but I also have a standard brush for the more detailed areas, and I've got a large dry brush as well for the really large areas, so the shoulder joint mainly, so that sort of thing. And what you do is just get some paint, and as always, put it onto your palette, and I'm going to thin it down with a little bit of water, just to help the paint flow a bit smoother. So what you've got to do is just start painting this onto the model on any parts that you want to be silver. And which bits you paint is, well, it's largely a matter of taste. I mean, I'm doing the leg on the joints around here, silver. And on the box art, these are yellow. So it's really up to you. So go around your model, just decide what you want to be silver. So I'm going to do things like the claws down here. There's also the lights as well. And whilst you're doing this, don't forget to do the same on the head and on the claw and the shooters as well. Now I've finished base coating the silver, I can move on to the next step, which is to shade it. And for this you're going to need Norn oil and also a wash brush, but I've also still got my standard brush on hand, and that's for any of the more finer detailed areas. And what you've got to do is get a good amount loaded onto your brush here, and then put it onto your palette. And you need to be generous with this part, because we need to shade all of the silver areas that we just painted. So you just got to quite liberally put this onto all these silver areas like this, so it's running into all that detail and shading it down nicely for you. Now as you're doing this, keep an eye on it to make sure that as the shade dries, it's not pooling anywhere. But also, you've got to be careful that you don't put on too much, because if you do, you run the risk of it starting to drip onto all those yellow areas, and then you've got to go and clean all those parts up again. So work around the whole model, doing all the silver areas like this, and then give it plenty of time to dry. You might find as you progress on the model that it starts getting tricky holding it, because there's so much of the wet shade all over it. In that case, just leave that bit to dry and move on to the next part on, say, the claw before coming back to this area once it's dried. So now that that Norn oil has dried, you can see it's given some really nice shading to all those silver areas. But before we move on to highlighting them, there's one more shade that I want to apply to them, and this time I'm going to use Agrax Earth Shade. Now, the reason I'm doing this, well, there's two reasons really. The first is that it's going to give it a slight oily appearance, and also it's going to darken these areas down a bit more, and I want these metallic areas to be really dark. So the process for doing this is going to be exactly the same as when we painted on the Norn oil. So I've got my same two brushes here. I'm going to load it up, and all you've got to do is start painting this over all of these silver areas, and you can see immediately it gives a slight oily appearance to them. So now that that Agrax Earth Shade has dried, you can see the kind of effect it's had on all of those silver areas. It looks kind of oily and greasy now. The next stage is to highlight these parts. Now for this I'm going to be doing a dry brush, and the colour I'm going to use is Necron Compound. So this is going to be very similar to when we were highlighting the black earlier on. If you get a medium dry brush and just load it up with a bit of paint, and then use some tissue like this just to work that paint in amongst all the bristles and get rid of any excess, because you really don't want very much on the brush here. So once you've worked down at it like that, and your brush is looking something like that, what you've got to do is start dry brushing this onto all the silver components, but aiming your brush carefully so that you're catching the edges, like round on this hip joint here. See how that bright silver line starting to appear along there? So what you've got to do is work around all these silver areas, lightly dry brushing it like this, and then we can move on. So now that the silver's highlighted, there's just one more step to go before we can move on, and that's to paint the pneumatic pistons. Now for this you need some Runefang steel, and I'm going to be using a standard brush. And just get a small amount of paint ready, and thin it down as well, just a little bit. And the parts I mean are on, say, these hydraulic pistons on the side of the legs. So these here. Paint this brighter silver on these components, the parts that would move on the inside of the piston up here. And this is because this metal would be smoother to allow it to operate. So with the pneumatic pistons done, the silver is now complete. And now I can move on to the next thing, which is going to be another metallic colour. And this time I'm going to be painting on some brass. Now I'm going to be using this to break up some of those large silver areas that we've just done, just to make them a bit more interesting. And also, I'm going to paint some of the glyph patterns on it as well. Now for this, you're going to need four paints. We're going to start out with a base coat of Balthazar Gold, and then we'll shade it with Agrax Earth Shade. After that, we're going to dry brush these areas with Golden Griffin, and then after that we'll do another dry brush with Necron Compound, and this is just for some fine highlights. So for the first stage with Balthasar Gold, you'll need two brushes. I'm going to be using a large brush for most of it, but I've also got a standard brush for the more detailed areas. So prepare your paint first of all on your palette and thin it down as normal, and also make sure you get that good sharp tip on your brush. And what you're looking to do is go around all these silver areas, and well, it's up to you really which parts that you paint with this colour. All you got to do is start choosing bits like this block back here, for example, just to break up these areas. So I might do this block and maybe this plate here. But also, whilst I'm doing these areas, I'm going to start painting the glyph patterns. And well, the most obvious one is this massive pattern on the front here. So I'm going to be doing all of this brass as well. So just go around the model and paint whichever parts feels right to you. And once the Balthasar Gold is dry, apply a shade of Agrax Earthshade across all of these areas. Now for this, I'm using a large brush here, and I've got a standard brush as well. And the reason I'm using these instead of a wash brush is because they give me just a bit more control where the colours meet the yellow, like around here. Because you need to be careful that you don't get any of that shade onto the yellow. After that, using a medium dry brush and some Golden Griffin, just very carefully dry brush around the edges of these bronze parts. So, like when we were doing the silver earlier, focus towards the edges just to give them a nice highlight like this. And then finally, still with a medium dry brush, just add a little bit of Necron Compound just to the very sharpest corners like this. And this will give a nice sharp highlight just to finish this brass off. And with that final dry brush, the metallics are now complete. And I've just dry fitted the arm on here so you can get an idea of how the brass is breaking up all that silver and what it looks like now. But with these parts done, we can move on to painting some of the details. Now the first of these I'm going to do are the headlights. And there's a couple of these around the model. Now to do this part, you'll need three colours. We're going to start out with a base coat of Cantor Blue. Then we're going to layer it with Rust Grey. And then finally I'm going to highlight it using White Scar. Now for all these colours I'm going to be using a fine detail brush, because as you're going to see, this is quite fine work. So when you're preparing your paint, make sure that you thin it down a little bit and make sure that you get a good fine tip on your brush. That's very important for this stage. Now what you need to do on your model is start painting this colour on these lights in between the metal bars. So as neatly as you can, just start filling that area in. Now notice I'm not going quite up to the edge, and that's because of that null oil that we shaded around there with earlier. I want to leave that around the corners so that it shades this part for me. So be as neat as you can on this stage and just take your time. So now that I've put the Cantor Blue on all of the lights, the next stage is to get some Rust Grey and paint it carefully into the middle light like that. Now I have thinned this paint down with a bit of water just to help it apply very smoothly. And when you get to these side parts, you just paint it towards the front of the light, so just there, but only go part way back and just leave it darker towards the edge, like that. And then finally, just paint a little bit of watered down White Scar just into the very middle of the light, just there, like that. And then, well, once you've done that, it's up to you now, but you can always put on some Art Coat Gloss Varnish onto these glass areas just to give them a nice reflective shine. So now I've added some Art Coat onto the glass, the lights are now complete. And now I can move on to the next detail, which is going to be the targeting lenses, which again are scattered across most of the body. Now for this we're going to need a couple of colours. We're going to start out with a base coat of Cantor Blue, then we're going to shade it with Norn Oil. After that we'll layer it with Rust Grey, and then Fenrisian Grey, and then finally do a very sharp highlight with White Scar just to finish it off. So the first colour is going to be Cantor Blue, and for this I'm going to be using a standard brush. So use your palette to prepare your colour and thin it down with a little bit of water. And this first step is, well, it's pretty easy this. All you've got to do is find the lenses, so I've got this great big one on the front of the body here, and just paint it completely with blue for this step. And then apply some Norn Oil, still with the standard brush, over the entirety of these lenses. And this is just to darken down that blue, because I want it to be a very dark blue on here. When the Norn Oil is dried, apply a thin line of Rust Grey using a detail brush that starts on the left-hand side up here and runs down underneath the lens. The next layer colour is Fenrisian Grey, and this is painted on in the same area, just a slightly thinner line this time, and a bit more focused towards the bottom left. And then the final part of the lens is just to paint a small amount of white scar with a fine detail brush just down in this corner here, and then put a small dot of white in the opposite corner like that, and there we go. Now if you want to, of course, you can just put on some hard coat to give that a nice glassy shine. I've chosen to put some hard coat over the lenses, and with that, they are now complete. So now I can move on to the final detail that we're going to be doing in this section, and that's to paint the cables. Now, there are quite a lot of cables all over the model, and to paint them, you'll need three colours. Now we're going to start with a base coat of corn red, then after that, we'll shade them using Agrax Earthshade, and then finally, we'll highlight them using Wazdaka Red. Now for the initial stage, for the base coat, I'm going to be using a standard brush. So get your corn red ready by popping it on the palette, and have a good look around the model to make sure that you catch all these cables. There are quite a lot of them. I'm going to start with these ones on the claw here, just down here. So all you need to do is get a good solid base coat over these. So as I say, as you're doing this, just make sure that you get them all, because there are quite a lot around the model. And once you finish the base coat, paint some Agrax Earthshade just into the corners here of the cables where they meet up with the metal of the hull. And doing this just gives a nice bit of shading and defines where they meet with the rest of the vehicle. And then the final part in the cables is just to highlight them using some Wazdaka Red and using a detail brush. And to do this, you just need to paint a line running along the top of the cable like that. And that just really helps define the shape of it. And with that final highlight done, the cables are now complete. And now, I've actually finished all the details that would have been really difficult for me to paint had I glued the entire model together in the first place. But now that those are done, I can stick on the claw and the head. Now, I'm going to give you some advice for doing this, and this applies for whenever you're sticking together sub-assemblies that have been painted. Just take a minute to get hold of your scraper, and on the join where you're going to be applying the glue, just scrape away some of that paint like that so you can see the plastic. I need to do this on both sides of the join, and what this means is when I put glue on there, I'll be gluing the plastic as opposed to the paint, so this will give you a much stronger join. Now, the glue I'm going to use is super glue thin, and you don't need to put on loads and loads. Just get some painted on onto the peg there like that, and then, well, it's a good idea to have a pose in mind before you stick this on. I know I want this claw to be raised up as if he's about to strike something. So just find the hole for the pin and just hold it in place. So once this is set, I'm going to glue on the head as well. So now I've glued on the arm and the head, there's just two more components left to stick to the model. But before I do that, I want to draw your attention to them, because it's very important that you fully paint the orc crewman before you stick on the shooters, because if you don't, you won't be able to fit the crewman in. Now we do have an in-depth tutorial on painting orc skin, so if you've not seen that yet, I recommend you go and watch it and use that technique for painting this guy's skin. But for all the other colours on him, for like his tunic and his hat, I'm going to be painting those in exactly the same colours and techniques that I've used for the rest of the vehicle. So I'm going to go and do that now, and then we can stick the final components together. So now that I've glued all the components together, the model is almost complete, and I'm really happy with how it's looking. So remember, when you're painting this stage of the Morkanaut, just be as neat as you possibly can, especially when you're dry brushing the metallic components. And also, when you're painting those parts with the shade, just make sure that none of that shade drips onto any of the yellow panels. Now, when you're doing your final assembly of all the components, just take a bit of time to clean up some of the joins and get the paint off them, so they get a stronger bond when they stick. And also, be certain to put in the orc crewman before you put on the shooters. So now, this part is done, we're going to be moving on to part three, and in that, I'm going to be showing you how to paint the horns, how to do some final weathering, and also a really cool effect to go on the force field generators.